Invasion of S.H.I.E.L.D., which you can catch on Friday at 8 on Channel 4. And don't forget, you can head to 4OD if you miss it. We're here with actor Rob Kazinsky, and you did just say, because everyone heard it, I think, that anything you're going to put in, you will come
yeah,
out
I'm
to
not,
you.
I'm not,
you're not feeling very well.
I'm good. I haven't had time. I've been working a lot. I haven't had time to get sick, so I'm just kind of manning through it, and I'm dosed up as you can be, and I'm good to go.
I do feel sorry for you, actually, because you've been suffering a bit this morning, haven't you?
It's fine. It's fine. It's not really suffering. No. You know, I'm the guy, if I get a moderate cold, I have man flu.
Right.
But I'm not allowed to get sick right now, so I'm just like...
Okay.
Getting through it.
All right, you're over from the States at the moment because you lived there, because you're the star of the new series True Blood. It's gone out in the States already, hasn't it? So does that mean now that you're just huge in the States everywhere? Because it's huge, isn't it?
It is a huge show, and it's certainly changed my life out there. It's got an incredible fan following. And a deserved fan following. It's a fantastic show. I mean, it's unlike anything. It's not like a...
Can you explain it to us for people who don't know?
Yeah, essentially, it's... There's, you know, vampires and supernatural creatures became very, very popular a long time ago. And a lot of it was aimed at kids, you know, all this Twilight glowing in the daytime, sparkly fairy stuff. And True Blood and Alan Ball just came in and went, well, you know what, vampires are scary. And we need a show that was aimed at adults, that didn't try and insult anybody's intelligence, and it was trying to be an almost realistic take on it, on what life would be like. And they created True Blood, where they used vampires as kind of a... they were used as a symbol to illustrate the kind of race divisions of the South, you know, in the past, and vampires were used as that device. And it created a show with an incredible following, with some incredible actors, and it's kind of gone from strength to strength to strength.
You said that you've been out in LA for 5 years.
Yeah.
So when you knew this part was up, did you go and audition for like everybody else, or were you approached about it?
I auditioned like everybody else, but I mean, that Pacific Rim was coming out at the time, and I got asked to go in and do it, and it was something we had been looking at for a while and we were ready for, and I got the sides. I went in, I met the producers, and then I did a chemistry read with Anna Paquin, who plays the lead Sookie Stackhouse in the show, and we hit it off great, and then before you know it, there I am on set, and it was amazing.
We can relate to you getting the job more than most actors, because you were in EastEnders. We all saw you in that, and now you've got over to... A lot of people come out of EastEnders and they don't end up making it big, do they? So you've come out and you made it big. Was it that moment when they said you got the job, you were like, oh my days, I've actually next level?
It's been a long time. I mean, people don't realize. I mean, it's been a long time. I left EastEnders in 2008. You know, that's 5 years ago now. Yeah. And, you know, in that time, things weren't easy. You know, it's a huge risk leaving a show like that, because it's steady money, it's a good job, and I was really happy there. And you come out, and I stayed in this country for a little while, and nobody would give me a job, and it was really, really difficult. And then I got given a job out of nowhere. George Lucas gave me a job in a movie called Red Tails, and it was a blink and you miss it scene, but it made me realize that perhaps I needed to go somewhere and start again, where people didn't have this preconceived opinion on who and what I was. And I went out to LA, and I struggled for a really, really long time, but the I got it moment was actually my very first job, which was on a show called Law and Order LA, where I played a meth dealing junkie who killed two kids. And I was like, but that was my first job. And it was huge to get on American television. And now it's just kind of like, I mean, I'm living a pinch yourself life, you know. I had a Hollywood premiere of a movie of mine this year I got to take my parents to. That's something you dream about as a kid. Yeah. You don't ever think it's going to actually come true, and it has done. I got a great role on a show that I love. I mean, I don't know what I did in a past life, because I certainly didn't do anything in this life that deserved this to happen to me. But in my past life, I must have been awesome, because I'm living the most blessed life you could have.
All right, let's have a little look at True Blood. Here you go, this clip.
You okay?
No.
You need me to call you an ambulance? Do you know what happened to you?
Smell my blood. My damn blood. Vampire attacked me.
Are you a fairy?
I'm a halfling.
Me too. Okay, you need a hospital.
No. Hospitals don't know what to do with fairies.
I feel a lot like that right now.
Yeah. You were just mentioned earlier you were in Pacific Rim and you went to Comic Con this year, was it?
Yeah, September, I think.
There you are.
Early September.
That's you.
I don't know when it was.
What is it? I've always thought that's fascinating. What is it like there? Is everyone dressed up?
Not everybody. But it's, you know, Comic Con started in 1970, I think, and it was just a bunch of fans who got together to celebrate comics and get together and exchange comics. And like over the last decade or so, comic books, you know, movies and stuff have become such a major thing in the world and people have really begun to adopt it. I grew up with comics. You know, we all want to be superheroes. And you go to Comic-Con and especially over the last few years, it's become very much a, you know, TV's got involved, films got involved, and there's so much money there now. Like there are, I think there were 300,000 people there this year or something silly. And there's people who go to incredible lengths to dress up in these amazing costumes.
I was in San Diego once when it was on. I had no idea of its existence. And you're just walking down the street thinking, what's going on? Because it's not just like minor fancy dress. This is proper, full-on.
Well, some people do it as a career.
Thousands on the,
people do it as a career. There are TV shows that follow these people. It's called cosplay. And a lot of my friends do it. And it's, I mean, I wish I could do it. You know, I mean, when I was a kid,
I used to good enough
but I used to sellotape pencils to my fingers when I was a kid and run around ruining my parents' walls. I used to get so angry, thinking I was Wolverine. Imagine how cool it would be to actually build a costume.
Yeah.
I mean, we all can't. It's a kid in all of us.
Tell him the story about when you were in a cafe.
So I'm there. So we're in a restaurant, and like, you know, I've finally figured out what Comic Con is. And the waitress says to me, "Goes, so are you guys here for Comic Con? You must be here for Comic Con." I'm thinking, who did I look like?
Have you seen Star Trek?
Very good. Ah, brilliant. So what's next for you then? What are you going to be doing next?
Well, we're still kind of like, I mean, obviously we've got True Blood coming out here September 30th on Fox. And we've got, still doing, Pacific Rim is coming out on DVD on October 15th. So we've got this, I'm kind of doing press all around the place to kind of make sure that people, you know, who didn't see the movie, see it on DVD, and those who did buy 18 copies of the DVD.
Yes.
And there's just a lot of, I'm still riding high off those things at the minute, and then we'll see what happens next.
Brilliant. Okay.
We'll have you back on.
Thanks for soldiering through.
He's really not well, is he? We'll have you back on as a guest when we're doing it live from LA, obviously.
Yes.
Yeah, fantastic.
All right, now, after the break, we're cooking a prawn curry with Michelin star chef Ashley Kutcher. See you.